Well, that tribal council was pretty stressful. Yeah, tell me about it.
Tribal council concerned me a lot. I knew going in I was gonna get votes, but I didn't expect it to be so close. I mean, like, there's only 7 votes that were counted, so someone didn't vote. I don't know who that is. But them not voting kinda saved me, because if I had gotten another vote, then it would have tied, and who knows what would have happened then.
So Taylor's gone. The question is, what next? Well, I think the 5 of us should stick together and just get rid of Jasmine. Or Alexa. Preferably Jasmine, though.
Yeah, I agree with that. At Tribal Council, I was the swing vote, and I sent Taylor home. I think it was probably the best move, because now I'm in this, like, majority alliance. And I think Max and Jack still trust me, and I know Rick and Seth do. The girls don't, but that's okay, because if we lose, one of them's going, and then, you know, I don't anticipate them being in the game for that much longer, so I should be fine.
Going into Tribal Council, I was anticipating the vote being between Max and Jasmine. But then all of a sudden, the majority fell on Taylor and she was gone. And that kind of came out of nowhere for me. And Brooke kind of clearly didn't vote Jasmine because Max and I did. And that's worrying to me because she kind of said that was what was going to happen. And then she went and did something completely different. So I'm not sure how much I can trust Brooke moving forward.
Well, Tribal sucked. I thought we had at least 4 votes going in there.
Yeah. Jasmine, I'm gonna be honest. It's my fault Taylor's gone. What, you voted for her? No, it's the opposite of that. I didn't vote. What do you mean you didn't vote? Well, I used my advantage. Oh, I see. Why did you do that? Because I thought we had the majority. I thought my vote didn't really matter.
Yeah, I guess it is your fault Taylor's gone then. Because, you know, we could have used that vote on Max.
I feel really bad about Tribal Council. I mean, Taylor was my ally, and she's gone because I didn't vote. I guess even if I did vote, it would have tied. But still, it's kind of my fault, and I don't really want to have that guilt on my shoulders.
Here, Jasmine. What's this? It's my extra vote. I want you to know, like, you can still trust me, we're still together. I want you to hang on to it,
I mean, you can play it if you want, but it's more of a show of trust than anything. Well, yeah, I'll hang on for it for you, Alexa, and, you know, we're still good, of course. Like, we've got each other and no one else. Yeah.
A tribal Taylor went home. It's not me, so at the end of the day, I don't really care all that much. Just sucks that Brooke went behind my back. Alexa decided to give me her extra vote. She said it was just, like, as a sign of trust or anything. But I'm not sure if she's gonna see it again. I mean, if she asks for it back, I probably will give it to her. But if she ends up, like, going home or something, then this thing's all mine. Granted, I'm probably next on the chopping block as opposed to her, so I could be in trouble if we don't win.
I'm kind of concerned. About what? Well, the idol's out there somewhere, so if Jasmine or Alexa find it, we could be in trouble. You're right about that, Seth. What should we do? Well, I think the 5 of us should go looking and just try to see if we can grab it before they do. Okay, then.
I thought it would be funny if everyone went around on an idol hunt. Obviously, I've got the idol, so it's like, you know, it's funny, right? I see everyone looking about, and I laugh, because at the end of the day, they're getting all nervous and scared. Oh no, we can't find the idol, what if they have it? But I got it, so it's funny.
Any luck, Rick?
Nope, can't say I found anything, Jack.
I wanted to spend the afternoon relaxing, but I can't do that because Seth wants everyone to go on like an Easter egg hunt minus the Easter eggs, because he's got the idol. Obviously, I'm going to have to play along and go looking through the bushes and whatever, because I don't want people to think I have it. But it's pointless. Why would we waste our energy looking for something he already has?
We did it, guys. We finally won a challenge.
Yeah. We all did great. It's nice to have a night off for once. You said it. We finally won a challenge, which is nice. If we had lost, things probably would have got messy really quickly. So I'm hoping we can win the next one and whatever comes after that, because, you know, this tribe, I think, is at its breaking point.
So, if we do end up losing the next challenge, it's going to be Sydney going, right?
Yeah, she's trying to, you know, make a move, so let's get rid of her.
Yep.
Yep, that's kind of what we all agreed on. Rebecca seems to be getting a little power hungry. I mean, I'm pretty close with Gordon and Toby. She just comes along saying like, oh yeah, Sydney's going home, we need to go to Sydney, I want to be in charge kind of thing. And it doesn't really sit well with me. I'm probably just going to stick with Rebecca though, because Sydney's trying to get votes on Gordon, so, you know, just going to have to keep an eye on her.
So is everything going, well? Yeah, for the most part. I'm just concerned if, like, we do go to Tribal Council, the votes are probably going to tie. Yeah, I see that. Yeah. Well, I do think Rebecca's going to stick with us, though. I think I'm pretty close with her, so... You know, if it ends up in a tie, I don't think she's going to flip on me, and I won't flip on her. Yeah, so I guess we should be prepared for a rock draw. Yeah, I guess so.
I'm feeling pretty confident right now. I'm in good with Malcolm and Rebecca, and I still got my majority alliance with
Gordon, Morgan, and Toby. So if we do end up going to Tribal, I'll probably be in the best spot out of everyone.
I'm not sure exactly how I should feel at this point in the game. I'm definitely great with Sydney, and I'm great with Rebecca. The other three, not so much. So if we do head to Tribal Council again, it's probably going to be a tie. And that scares me, so I might have to play the idol if we head to Tribal just to increase the odds of my alliance getting our way.
Welcome, survivors. Your next immunity challenge. First things first. Fate-Rod Tribe. Getting a look at the new Volana Tribe. Taylor, voted off of the last Tribal Council. Alright, let's get into today's immunity challenge. This is how it's going to work. You'll divide your tribe up into three pairs of two, and these pairs will balance on a platform. The first tribe to have a member of each of the three pairs drop will be going to Tribal Council. Volana, you got one extra member, someone sitting out. Give you guys a moment to strategize, and then we'll get started.
Alright. Both tribes have people up, and this challenge is on.
And just moments into this challenge, Toby and Malcolm fall. Fitra is down to two pairs.
And Seth falls off, meaning Volana is also down to two pairs. The four pairs up seem to be hanging in there well enough.
Rebecca slips off. Fitra down to their last pair in this challenge.
Morgan and Sydney need to hang on, or else their tribe will be going to Tribal Council for the third time this season.
Alexa falls off. It is down to Jack and Brooke for Volana.
Jack and Brooke hanging on well.
But Morgan and Sydney lose their balance, meaning Volana wins immunity once again.
It was definitely a great feeling to be one of the last people up in that challenge and to, you know, bring home the win for the tribe. We get another night off, and that's great, considering how the last tribal went. I don't need to deal with any more stress for the time being.
Well, this sucks. Yeah, you said it.
I hate losing. It's just so frustrating because that challenge, we could have won that. Except I fell, like, instantly, and then, you know, we just couldn't hang on.
So what should our plan be tonight?
Well, of the two, I think we should keep Rebecca and get rid of Malcolm.
Really? How come?
I just think it would be smarter to get rid of him. He's going to be a physical threat later on, and, you know, I think it's better to get rid of him than Rebecca.
Yep, that's what we're doing.
Okay, fine by me.
Alright.
So, we're going to be on the same page tonight?
Yeah, I would hope so.
Yep, we're voting Gordon, right?
Yeah, he is the head of that alliance, and, you know, getting rid of that social threat is good for all of us.
Tonight, I'm looking to take a shot at Gordon. He's definitely the biggest threat here, in terms of his social ability. So, getting rid of him would just be the best thing that could happen.
Sydney's just running around at this point. It's concerning.
Yeah, just hoping Rebecca keeps her word.
Yeah.
Tonight's vote concerns me because Sydney is out there running around and trying to push votes onto me, it looks like. I think I should be fine because I trust Toby and Morgan. I know they have my back. It really just comes down to if Rebecca's actually going to work with us or not.
So what's up, Rebecca?
Well, Sydney wants it to be you, Gordon, and that's not happening.
You're with us?
Yeah, 100%. She's going home.
Sydney is just... no. You know, she just seems so disingenuous. She's sneaky. She's trying to play the middle. And she's gonna go home tonight. I really want it to happen, and I think the numbers are there. The only thing left to decide is if I tell Malcolm. He's my number one ally, but I also know he's close with Sydney, so I don't really know if I should let him know what's going on tonight.
So what do you think about tonight, Toby?
Well, I think we should be fine. Sydney's going home.
Yeah, I'm not so sure about that.
What do you mean?
Well, she's playing, like, super aggressively right now. You know, she's talking to everyone. She's running around.
Well, yeah, she's trying to make a big move.
Exactly. I feel like she might have an idol, and that's why she's playing so, like, risky.
Yeah, she might, but if she does have one, and she plays it, it's not going to be one of us going home.
I know, but I think we should try to split the vote here and just be safe.
Yeah, I don't know if that's wise. I mean, if Rebecca's not with us, that's basically screwing over Gordon. Plus, you know, I don't think she's got anything.
You can never be sure.
Yeah, well, you're just getting paranoid. Anyway, I'm going to have a nap. Let me know if anything changes before Tribal.
Yeah, sure, I guess.
Toby shot down my plan to split the vote, which kind of sucks. I do think it would be the smarter choice just to be safe. And then he decided to take a nap, which I think is a stupid thing, because this is a $1 million game, and we're about to, you know, go to Tribal Council and vote someone off, and he's just throwing away strategy time to, what, sleep? I don't get it, but, you know, if that's what he wants to do, then, you know, he can do it.
Hey, you got a minute, Malcolm?
Yeah, what's up?
I think things should change tonight regarding the vote.
Why?
I think we do Sydney here.
What? Why? She's with us.
Yeah, I know, but we're just, like, gonna go into a tie, and I think it's wise to just get rid of Sydney, and then, you know, go from there.
I don't like that idea, honestly.
Yeah, well, we have nothing to lose. If she goes, we're still together, we still have an idol, and we're probably just gonna swap tribes next round, so I think it's just the best thing to do.
I don't know, though, Rebecca. I think keeping Sydney really helps our games.
I don't know about that. I don't think she's really with us.
So right before Tribal Council, Rebecca straight up tells me things are changing to Sydney. And I don't understand why. She's with us. And I don't see the point. I really hope Rebecca changes her mind because I don't want Sydney to go. I want us to, like, have a chance to have the numbers, you know?
Welcome, Fit Red Tribe, to Tribal Council. So, Malcolm, how does it feel to be back here for a third time?
Well, it's a bad feeling, Jeff. I think we all wanted to, you know, get a win streak going, but we lost, so now we gotta vote someone off.
Toby, how do you feel about the losses?
I'm tired of losing. I think that we're a strong tribe, and we just gotta bounce back. You know, today I took a nap. Hopefully that gets my energy up, and hopefully, you know, I'll be well-rested for the next immunity.
You took a nap?
Does that mean you feel like you're pretty safe tonight?
Yeah, I haven't heard my name come up, and, I was cued in on the plan, so I think I should be fine.
Well, how about you, Rebecca? Are you cued into the plan?
I think so, yeah.
How about you, Gordon?
I hope so.
All right, well, then I guess it's time to vote. Morgan, you can start us off.
Well, you've been throwing my name out, so I'm going to have to vote you off tonight.
The game moves fast, and tonight I think you're probably going to be surprised by this.
You're a big social threat, so I'm hoping that tonight things will go my way and you will get blindsided.
I've tallied the votes. If anyone has the hidden immunity idol and would like to play it, now would be the time to do so.
Jeff, I got something for you.
I'm hoping this works out tonight, Jeff, so...
Malcolm, don't play it.
Why not?
You don't need to. Don't waste it.
You know what, Rebecca? I'm gonna try to make a move here. Jeff, I'm playing this on Sydney tonight.
This is the hidden immunity idol. Any votes cast for Sydney will not count. I'll now read the votes.
First vote. Sydney does not count. Second vote. Sydney
Does not count. Third vote. Gordon. That's one vote for Gordon, three votes left. The fourth vote. Malcolm. That's one vote Gordon, one vote Malcolm. Gordon. That's two votes Gordon, one vote Malcolm, one vote left. The final vote. Malcolm. We have a tie. Alright, this is how it's going to work. We will re-vote. Malcolm and Gordon will not vote. Everyone else will vote. You can only vote for Malcolm and Gordon. If the votes tie again, rocks will be drawn. I'll give you guys a moment to discuss your vote. Morgan, can I talk to you, like, really quick? Yeah, sure. Okay, what's happening? What are we doing? Well, we're keeping our vote the same. And if Rebecca doesn't flip, then, you know, that's her mistake. Well, all right. Listen, Rebecca, you gotta vote Gordon, please. No. I mean, you're just gonna vote me off? Listen, Malcolm, I don't want to go to rocks, and I think you playing the idol is stupid, so please, just give it a shot. I don't know. Alright, is everyone ready? Yep. Alright, Morgan, you're first up, take the urn back with you.
Well, things played out pretty well, I would say. See ya, Malcolm. Well, tonight was unexpected. I don't really know what else to say other than that.
I have tallied the votes. Once the votes are read, the decision is final. Person voted off will be asked to leave the tribal council area immediately. I'll now read the votes. First vote, Malcolm. Second vote, Gordon. That's one vote Malcolm, one vote Gordon, two votes left. Third vote, Malcolm. That's two votes Malcolm, one vote Gordon, one vote left. The final vote. And the fourth person voted off of Lego Survivor Madagascar. Malcolm. Malcolm, that's three, that's enough. For tonight, I'll need you to bring me your torch. Malcolm, the tribe has spoken. It's time for you to go.
Well, tonight, I don't really know what to say. I got outplayed. I wanted to make a big move. I wanted to keep Sydney in the game. And that completely blew up in my face. I didn't expect them to vote me. Didn't expect them to split the vote at all. And, I'm paying the price because of it. I wish Rebecca would have, you know, kept me on the revote, but I understand why she didn't want to go to rocks and all that. Man, I look like such a fool. I should have just not played the idol.